you awake? I thought I heard you get up.
Yeah, I'm awake. Sorry, I just can't sleep.
Are you thinking about him?
Yeah, a bit. You should get back to sleep, my love. I'm fine.
No, it's okay. What else is on your mind?
I don't know. It seems weird, but I had one of the most vivid dreams of my life. I saw a fox on a snowy mountain, just looking confused and worried. Those eyes. I can't get those eyes out of my head. She was running in the windy snow, looking for something.
So peaceful.
Do you think it has to do with you and what's been going on?
I don't know. It was just a dream, Rachel. They're not meant to make sense. A lot's happened the past couple days, that's all.
Well, if you're not going to sleep anyway, you should tell me. I want to hear.
Yes, that was.
All right. Far from her home, she followed that path to something unexpected.
What is it?
She couldn't stay, though. She had to find her other two children. So she took that path. She followed it towards something ancient.
Oh, no.
Something with answers. Slipped high and low, searching for any sign of her cubs. Points of light showed the way to this ancient tree. It was as if each one had a story to tell, all their own. The land was trying to tell my story, too. I felt like I was right behind her the whole time.
Oh, the sounds are so great. The sound of rain. So calm and peaceful. Although it looks like it's a very sad story. Well, I'm so relaxed right now.
Way of putting it. Wood was a canvas, and a carving knife was his paintbrush. Even after working 50 hours, even after his hands were splinters than skin, he would bring home the nicest piece of Alaskan weeping sea and make me toys. That wooden train was the first toy I can remember, and I loved it. I just knew from a young age I was going to be a lumberjack, like my father.
Story. It's very nice.
wasn't popular or unpopular. Maybe just forgettable. I guess that gave me a sense of freedom. So I hung out with crazy kids, doing crazy things, even though I mostly just watched the chaos ensue. We did it all. Put fireworks in mailboxes, hide roadkill in people's garages, break windows at the barbershop in Anchorage. My dad was furious, but he was so busy working he couldn't do much to stop him from going out.
I think being an adult means there's no one to stop you making hard decisions. He had to make a
living. Look at the bottom line.
Two places at once.
I thought they were just shadows.
He was more interested in growing his business than what was going on with me.
How am I supposed to get them?
saying how bored they were and how they had come all the way out to my house for nothing. One of them mentioned how that old, ugly, beyond belief truck was still in the garage and how we should take it for a spin. I was only 15, so I kind of fought it for a while. The next thing I knew, we were careening around the mountain path, rocks spitting onto the sides of the cliff, while my dad's cringeworthy bluegrass blared out the speakers. I drove while my friends were in the back of that yellow and purple truck, throwing beer bottles and trash at anything remotely interesting. I felt like I was soaring in the air with borrowed wings. But all good things have endings. A cop outside of Eagle River pulled us over after he saw us in a bottle rocket into someone's yard. What followed was a long night of talking to disappointed adults and feeling smaller than ever. After he drove me home from the police station, I blew up at him, saying how I never wanted to be like him, so I was gonna be someone and leave that hick icebox for good. He just looked forward at the road with tired eyes. I took out that bluegrass tape from the cassette deck and chucked it out the window. In my sage teenage wisdom, I thought I had proved the ultimate point, but my dad had a different idea. He slammed the brakes, slowly bowed his head while gripping the steering wheel, and finally looked at me. All he said, like it was a polite request, was, "Make this right."
I
sat there in silence, fuming, but I eventually got out and combed every square inch of the woods, muttering profanity after profanity. I found it 30 minutes later, near a small waterfall off the road. Went back to the truck, put the wet tape back in, and sure enough, it worked. He didn't speak another word to each other the rest of the night.
Wow, I knew you were a crazy teenager, but...
It's hard to believe, isn't it? It surprises me, too. It's like I didn't really know who that kid was back then. I bet my dad thought the same thing over and over. It's almost like he was saying, make this right to himself, more than to me.
Obviously. Jump.
And I laughed along, pretending it didn't bother me. But it did. I imagined my friends growing old in the bush, unable to find that thrill in those godforsaken ice fields. It's like those mountains were a literal wall, keeping me from leaving, where all I would have to look forward to are lumber yards and evening beers. I had to climb over. That was my only goal for a long time. If there was some way I could take my love of drawing and turn it into a way of escape, nothing would make me happier. I wanted to create instead of tearing trees down. I wanted to move to the lower 48, not because I hated it there in Alaska, but I hated the idea of it. It's like all of that spite inside me had created this monster which followed me around my whole teenage years. I put so much energy into doing what others didn't expect of me. Why did I do that?
There's one fact you're forgetting, though. If you didn't have that fire in you, we probably would have never met.
You're absolutely right. Maybe the destination is all that matters in the end. Then why am I awake? Why am I seeing this fox go on her journey? And why can't I stop thinking about my dad?
Thank you so much for watching. See you next time. Bye-bye.